morning. It's Friday the 10th of January, February. Friday the 10th of February 2017. Do you know, I still seem to be stuck in 2016 and the month before of January. Do you find that when you're writing those checks? Don't write checks anymore, do you? Oh, can I pay my check? Oh, no, no. Oh, no, we don't do checks. Don't do checks or anything like that, do they? No. Well, good morning to you. It's very dark and dreary outside, I must say. There's like a mist outside. It's the fog. And we're all going to be attacked. Yes, it's the fog. Good morning to our early people this morning. Joe is with us. Good morning, Joey. Have you got your thing yet? Which was sent in the post. Maybe not yet. It's second class, dear. Second class. I send certain things first class and other things second class. Your item is arriving second class, Jerry, all right? Good morning to Adam. We're going to talk about you in a moment, Adam. Another round of applause for Adam coming up shortly. Good morning to Kevin Webster. Wendy's with us this morning. Oh, I haven't got that thing fired up. Just a moment. Let's just do the that thing there. I didn't put the number up, did I, this morning? I haven't put the phone number up. I don't think I can do that now. I'll read it out in a minute when we open the lines, OK? Good morning to Jason Carter, who says, how's your happy Friday? It's always happy here in Royal Berkshire, dear. It's always a happy, happy time. Don't worry about that here in Berkshire. There's no snow here. Here in the United Kingdom Talk weather studio, I'm getting report of snow all over the country. I was just talking to my niece, who's in hospital at the moment. Poor little thing. Oh, bless her. She's got gastroenteritis, I think it's called. Gastroenteritis. Yes, both ends. Not pleasant. And she's quite a few months having a baby in a couple of months' time. So they've got her in hospital at the moment. And I rang her this morning around about 8:45. She is bored senseless. They've got her own little room. She's got her own little room because it's quite a contagious thing, it would seem. And she can't hold any food down. So she's got, I think it's, she said creatones or something in her blood, which means her body has started to eat its own fat. Not that she is fat, but her body has started to eat because there's no other food. And I thought, well, maybe I should go over there and pick it up from her for a while. Can you choose to have something like gastroenteritis, you know, for, say 3 weeks? That would get rid of my excess fat, you know, or the stroke. No dieting. No cutting back on anything. No exercise. You just go and get a disease for a few months and then go back to the hospital, ask them to cure you. That's it. Problem solved. Just a suggestion. So she's up there at the moment. And I said, have you got a television in your room? Get this, right? Have you got a television in your room? Well, I've bought one just for today. I said, well, look, how much? What do you mean? Because, of course, they rent them in the hospital. Do they still have TV rooms in hospitals? I always remember whenever I visited people in hospital, my mum went in a couple of times, my dad went in a couple of times, and at the end of the ward would be a television room. And you'd go in these, and you were allowed to smoke in there. Do you remember that? You'd go down the end of the ward, and then you'd go open this door, and my... and, and the clouds of smoke that would come out of these doors, and a nurse would close those doors. And you'd sit in there. Well, you couldn't see the telly through the clouds of smoke. Honestly. And of course, you know, you'd have to watch what the majority would be watching. And it was only like four channels, I think. Three channels. It might have only been three channels last time I went into one of those rooms. Do they still have a television room? Obviously not with smoking in it anymore. People used to be getting nearly better in hospitals years ago. They'd go and watch a couple of hours of television in that smoking room. They'd come out again with more wrong than them than they went in the TV room with. Do they still have them, I wonder? Anyway, so no, she hasn't got one of those. She had to buy it for one day's television watching. How much? Go on, have a guess. Have a guess. Go on, have a wild stab in the dark. Couple of quid, you know, £10 a week. £7.50 a day. £7.50 to hire a bloody television in an hospital. It's outrageous, isn't it? Actually, why hasn't she got... I'm sure she must have a tablet of some sort. She could watch it on there. That's legal, isn't it? If you've got a licence at home, I'm sure it is. She should have... I'll have to suggest that to her, actually. Or my sister. She's got a tablet. I'm not sure what one she's got. maybe an iPad or something like that. She could surely watch the television on there. Why is she hiring a bloody television for £7.50? But last night, I said to her on the phone, what did you watch last night? She said, well, there was nothing to watch. So I paid an extra extra for an extra £2.50. You have a selection of 75 films you can choose for. In American, movies. Films, movies, movies, films. Yes, I like to translate sometimes for our international viewers all over the world. Boys, this is international. This is no local thing. This is not a local thing. It's an international, dear. Global programme this is. So she paid £10 yesterday for a few old television programmes. She couldn't find anything she wanted to watch on the telly. So then paid another £2.50 to watch a film. I don't know what film she watched. I doubt it would have been something like Hospital, which is a horror film. It's like, you know, when you're on an airplane and that film comes on, Airplane. Do you watch that one on the plane? I didn't think so either. Oh, it's 10 o'clock. We're early today, aren't we? Back to your messages, boys and girls. As I say, good morning to Gustav. Don't forget to twiddle the knob. I have forgotten. Button pushed. Thank you, Gustav. Please remind me every time. Because there's a button I have to press just in the hope that someone will call in later on. I'll open the line straight after these messages, all right? Wendy's going to get a coffee. Not too much, Wendy. You don't want heart palpitations. Boom, 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 boom. I get terrible heart palpitations but just before I come on and talk to you. That's true. That is true. Good morning to Ray Reynolds from the George Formby Society. Good morning, Ray Reynolds, who's with us. Ross says, come on, Chris, get on with it. Were you watching the countdown, Ross? That's what it's for, dear. A countdown. It counts down to the show. Do you know why there is a countdown? Go on. Any idea why? Go on, have a guess, Ross. I'll wait for your message. Why would I put a countdown on there and not just switch on and get going? Any idea? Good morning to Tim Partington. Morning. Loving the new poster for Central Station. I've made two new posters, boys and girls, which you will see appear. You'll see one of them appear straight after the show on my Facebook wall, advertising tonight's karaoke at Central Station every Friday, 8:30 to midnight. And every Monday with cheap drinks, 8 o'clock till 11:30. One of the new posters is coming up for your viewing shortly. OK. Good morning to Jimmy Butler, my business owning nephew. Yes, he fixes dents in cars and does all that rubbing down and paint work and all that. Actually, he did a very, very good. I think it was someone's bumper. And he did a before picture and an after picture. And the before picture, there's all these cracks in it and what looked like wrinkles. And the after picture, it was perfectly, well, it looked like new. Looked like new. And I did suggest to my nephew, Jimmy Butler, international, that he could do the same for his mum's face, my sister. Because there's a lot of old wrinkles there. Oh, dear me. Motorcyclist with mini motes tried to go across her face once while she was out. They thought it was a dirt track. They thought it was a dirt track going across her face like that, all over the place. They were coming out from, because there's so many lines going in so many different directions. All these mini moat people were coming out of them in all directions, they do. Yes, awful. Actually, we've got someone with a mini moat round the back here who keeps going down the paths. I must ring up the police next time. Let's see them. Yes, we like to dob people in it, don't we? Tim says it's 324 days to Christmas. Well, perhaps this year, Tim, you might want to save up for a present from me then. You know, I don't really seem to remember receiving anything from you yet, whether at Central Station, Belushi's or anywhere. No present yet. And if you want to talk about time, get this. We are a third of the way through February already. Only 3 weeks till Lent. What are you giving up this year? Exactly. Gustav says, I look anemic. Right. I'm glad you brought that up, Gustav. There is a bit of a problem with the new camera. Basically, if I try and turn the colour up, which I'm going to do now, if you're watching a recording of the show, incidentally, the sound is plugged in today. Don't worry about that. The picture will start jumping. I'm going to turn the colour up now. There you go. Now, you see that picture has started jumping, OK? Turn it back down again and it stops. Turn it up and it starts jumping again. We don't know what is causing that. I've checked out help files, you know, and forums and things like that. And I can't find anyone else who's had the problem. So what I think I'm going to do on the next live show, I'm going to put the other camera back in position. Now, where is that actually? I think it's up there somewhere. Where is that other little camera? Hello? Are you there? Oh, it's disappeared. Well, it must be here somewhere. One moment, please. I'm sure it's here. Just a second. Is it up there? I might put it up there. One moment. It's so, honestly, it's a real mess in here. Where's that other camera gone? Dear me, look at it. Aha, what's that? Oh, there it is. Here's the other camera. It's only small. It's only small. It appears like closer to me, so you would only see kind of from there to there, I think, if I remember rightly. I can't remember exactly. But this works perfectly. Apart, the new one is wider, but I can't turn the colour up. And it is only the colour setting. I've tried the other settings and things like that. So what I might do on the next live show is set this up. What is it tomorrow? Saturday? We might do one tomorrow. Excuse me, I've got hiccups. I might set this up tomorrow. And I'll flick between the two like a test. We'll do a test thing. And you'll have to tell me which one you would prefer. I'm aware how pasty I'm looking on that. But as you saw, you can't turn the colour up because it starts going funny, right? So thank you very much for that. Gustav, you led nicely into that. Thank you very much, Gustav. Good morning to Robert Cooper, who's with us this morning. Look, there she is, Tracey Clifford. If you want to send her messages of goodwill, please do so. That's my niece on there, Tracey Clifford. I didn't know you was with us today, dear. Nice little chat on the phone to you earlier. Good morning to John Child. John, are you coming tonight? Because I've got your item with me. Your item, okay? Ross says, the colour of the video today is horrible, nearly in black and white. Yeah, well, that's the reason, I'm afraid. Not a lot I can do about it. It's not a lot I can do about it. Look, I'll tell you what. Stop you bloody well moaning. Do you want me to plug this in there? Oh, I don't know if that's going to work, will it? No, that won't work. I can't do it on the hock, I don't think, no. So we're just going to have to put up again. All right, we'll have to put up with it. Ross is in Australia. Yes, indeed. The phone number, if you want to call in, is... Are you ready? It's a local London number. You'll have to write it down because I forgot to put it at the top today. 020-8144-3477, OK? 020-8144-3477. That is the phone number. Now, going back to my niece and her television story... So for another £2.50, she had a choice of about 75 films, most of which she'd seen 200 times before. But what you don't want is a KODI box. Who's got a KODI box? Any of you got a KODI box? I know, some of you are the same as me. What is a KODI box? What is a KODI box? I don't know what a KODI box is. What is a KODI box? It is an illegal box in the BBC. Da, 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 da. In the BBC website this morning, I think this came out yesterday or the day before, actually. Five people have been arrested, accused of selling set-top boxes modified to stream subscription football matches. Well, that wouldn't be of interest to me. Movie channels and television channels for free. This is a little box that apparently, I don't know where you would buy. Do you get this from Garri's or do John Lewis do these? I doubt that very much, dear. There's nothing illegal going on in John Lewis. There never is. The scale of the so-called fully loaded KODI boxes has been called a top priority by the Federation Against Copyright Theft. Called FACT. F-A-C-T. They love those initials, don't they? They love initials. FACT says it believes the suspects has made in the region of £250,000 selling the boxes online. KODI is free software. Oh, it's software, is it? So presumably you could put it on your computer. I don't know. Oh, I wouldn't do that. No, viruses, dear. Viruses, I'm very, very particular. What I open on my computer, you must be aware of viruses, okay? KODI is free software built by volunteers to bring videos, music, games and photographs together in one easy-to-lose application. Some shops sell legal set-top boxes and TV sticks, often called KODI boxes, preloaded with the software. Well, that says it's legal. There's some shops sell... Oh, maybe there's two different types. The developers behind KODI say that their software does not contain any content of its own and is designed to play legally owned media or content freely available on the internet. However, the software can be modified with third-party add-ons that provide access to pirated copies of films and TV series or free access to subscription channels. The sale of these so-called fully loaded boxes is currently the subject of illegal... So I assume it's not illegal to buy them. So 5 arrests have been made in the UK, all over the place. Bolton, Bootle, Cheadle. Where is Cheadle? Manchester and Real. I think that's in Wales, isn't it? set-top boxes loaded with apps and add-ons allowing access to copyright infringing material are very much illegal. Anyone involved in selling these boxes should not be surprised to receive a knock on the door from Mr. Plod. Yeah, so there we are. I suppose this is people who've got nothing better to do than sit there watching a blooming television all day long, don't they? Oh, my word. I wish I had enough time to watch the telly. You know, I watch bits and pieces of the telly. I'm at the moment halfway through Sunday's Taboo, which I'm enjoying that series so much. Taboo, are you watching it? I'm halfway through that. And I just started last night, because I can watch several programmes at the same time. You know, I watch a bit of that. Oh, I'll watch a bit of that now. I'm also about 10 minutes into Holby. From Tuesday Night, which I quite like. I like the two gay characters in that. You know the two characters? There's a young one who's kind of pretty-ish, and there's an old one who's very handsome. I do not like that old one at all. He's horrible. He's really horrible. He's very, very controlling. We don't like... People have tried to control me before. Women and men. Let me tell you that. And it doesn't work. No chance whatsoever of controlling me. Not even at work, I just go. Oh, God, oh, thank you, I've had enough, bye-bye. Oh, where are you going? I'm leaving. Well, you can't leave. Yes, I am, I can't be bothered with you, bye-bye, and I just go. That's the end of it. Thank you very much, goodbye. I love it. I love it when you leave a job. Okay, because horrible bosses, and I've worked with a few horrible ones before, not at the moment. I have no horrible, oh, I would say that anyway, wouldn't I? Be honest, but actually, I do not have any horrible bosses at the moment. In fact, there's a few of them who are really appreciative of what I do. And you can't ask for any more than that. You really can. But in the past, I have. And when you tell them they're leaving, they're like, you're leaving. They're like, what, you're leaving? Yeah. And they can't believe it. These are the same people that are horrible to their staff and sack people. You know, for the slightest thing. I leave. I love it. I'm leaving tomorrow. Oh, well, you can't leave. Why? There's no contract. You can sack me tomorrow. So I'm leaving first. Ha ha! I love it. Back to these messages, boys and girls. Tim says, thank you, Tim. Tim says, I do love the countdowns. Reminds me of the old programme for schools and colleges on ITV and Channel 4. Do you not remember the ones on the BBC as well, Tim? Eh? BBC television for schools and colleges. Yes. Good morning to my sister, who says, I look a lot older than you and I have deep cracks in my face. And Jimmy Butler cannot repair those. And my sister's there. The whole family's watching this morning. Thank God for that. We're desperate for viewers. You know, we're down to 8 million this morning. Look at that. Ray Reynolds says it's a bit more colourful now. Thank you, Ray. Well, I've turned the colour up a bit, but I can't do an awful lot with it. I'm really not sure what to do. But we'll try the cameras on. Both tomorrow at some point if I can, okay? John, you shouldn't admit things like that on the internet, dear. You don't know who's watching that. John says he's got one of those boxes and he paid £95 for it. Well, there you go, John. Dear me. You really shouldn't. And you don't know who's watching this. There might be people on their way home round to your house at the moment, John. And where are you going to have to drink? You'll have nothing to drink. You'll have nothing to watch while you're drinking out of that mug, dear. God's sake, mate. Cheadle is in Cheshire. Thank you. I didn't know where that was. Tim also sends some stuff about the KODI box. Taboos on Saturday nights. Oh, is it Saturdays? I do not like Let It Shine. I like that. I haven't seen last Saturday's show yet. Let It Shine with Garri Barlow and that bloke from... Spandau Ballet, Martin Kemp, isn't it? And that lovely, I love the lady on there. What's her name? From Glee, isn't she? I can't remember. Big lady. Oh, she's fab. And the bloke at the other end. I can't remember who it is now. I don't remember who it is now. John Child enjoys Roots on BBC Four. That's an old programme, that, isn't it? Very old. Good morning to Mari. Good morning, Mari. Nice to see you this morning, darling. And Danny Minogue is the other one. Thank you very much. Danny Minogue is very honest, I must say. Danny Minogue, she's a bit honest, isn't she? She's very honest. Right, now let's talk about some stuff then. First of all, we need to congratulate Adam this morning. Adam, this morning, is now a member of Slimming World and has been there for some time, boys and girls. And last night, he had his little appointment at Slimming World and he says, Slimming World smashed it tonight, £6 off again in a week. Is that in a week? He's lost £6 in a week. So now he's lost a total of £1 and £3. Oh, the Americans want to know what that is. Okay. Oh, that's 14. What's that? £3. That's 14. I suppose it's 16. Is it 16? I think it's 14 stone. Is it 14 stone? In £14 and 14, 15. He's lost about £17. Something around about 17, 18, 19 pounds. That's how much Adam has lost in, I think, 3 weeks. Very well done, Adam. Come on, gang. Slimmer's World. I need to join one of those. I need to lose about a stone. That's true. Well done, Adam. Very, very impressed with you indeed. And keep it up, sir. Keep up. Keep it up indeed. Thank you very much. Yes. So that's that. So we've got a couple of news stories to do today. How about some of that cosmetic surgery? Ever had that done? Cosmetic surgery, a little bit here, a little bit there. My mate's had that done, but don't tell him I told you that. Oh, yes, he's had a few injections in the face. What's he call it? Fillers. Now, I don't think fillers is Botox. I think it's a different thing. I'm not 100% sure on that. Are fillers Botox? And don't forget, you can ring in if you want to. 020-8144-3477 is the number. Have you had cosmetic surgery? 020-8144-3477. In the Daily Mail this morning, women are spending thousands of pounds on a new cosmetic procedure to create dimples in their lower backs. Why? Who sees that, mind you? Looking at some of the girls out sometimes in the R Street, dear. They barely got anything on. I can see the day coming where people are walking around completely naked. We're like going back in time, aren't we? It's like Adam and Eve. They were naked, dear, running around the forest, picking naughty apples off the trees. Naughty Adam and Eve. Which one was it that picked the apple? Was it Adam? Who picked that apple? Naughty Adam. Nicknamed the Venus Dimple, athletic models Kendall Jenner and Miranda Kerr. Who are they? Anyone know? Never heard of them. Are among the famous women who've shown off their natural dents on either side of their lower spine. Said to be indicators of good health, the dents are difficult to achieve through exercise as they're located where the two pelvic bones connect. So those who aren't naturally blessed are now going in search of a cosmetic solution. I wonder if I've got those. Can I ask you, can you have a look? Have I got those or is there any there? Can you see? Have I got those cosmetic dents? Venus dimples. Do I have those? Witnessing her client's interest in improving the area prompted London-based surgeon Dr. Amanda Wong Powell, the founder of the W1 Wellness Clinic, located just off Harley Street, to develop her V-spot treatment. The doctor says the V-spot is a curved diamond area in the back and is usually found naturally on the body of very sporty and athletic women. This is why a lot of women want to go under the knife to have their V-spot done, because they want to look young and fit. Don't we all? Don't we all? Once it's gone, it's gone. You can probably lose a bit of weight, like Adam has done. 1 stone, 6 pounds again, was it, Adam? Congratulations, sir. The lower back has always been championed as a beautiful region of the female body, she added. However, with the rise of aesthetic surgery of the buttocks, many people are realizing... I need some of that, I think. Aesthetic surgery on the buttocks. I have to drag mine around on the floor now. It's true, dear. Honestly, I've got to say, it's been a bit of a rush last night. I picked up this pair of jeans off the floor and I had to dash into McDonald's last night because, you know, I got a bit of a problem with IBS, irritable bowel syndrome. So I'm driving to work last night. Oh God, I need to go. I had to pop in, or rush in more like, I had to rush into the McDonald's on the Wandsworth roundabout last night on the way to work. Oh, it's awful. It's awful. I haven't missed yet. It hasn't happened yet. You know what I mean? Has it happened to you before? I've managed to just about get to the lavatory in time, dear. How awful. Back to this. However, with the rise of aesthetic surgery of the buttocks, I like that word, buttocks. Would you prefer buttocks or bum? Or arse? What do you prefer? Buttocks, bum or arse? I prefer arse. I quite like the word arse. Do you like that? However, many people are realising that lifted buttocks only look good if paired with a sexy sculptured lower back. One fails to look good without the other, apparently. So you can get your bum done. What's the point of having your bum done and nothing happens? And what do they do to lift it again? Do you have to have something put in there or sucked out? Can't you just buy special knickers and underpants, you know, that make your bum look nice? You know, because, you know, let's face it, girls. You know, once they're in your bedroom, they're not going to say no, are they? So, you know, you might take off your knickers or your pants or something like that. And if it all falls out, doesn't matter. They're already there. Oh, I can see hundreds of people like that going out with special... I bet you can buy special pants and special knickers to make your bum look nice again. And you're out there chatting up some man, girls, aren't you? Like that, aren't you? We're chatting up some man, eventually you get them back to your house and they're all excited and you take your knickers and that off and your bum just falls apart. But it doesn't matter. They're already there. They're not going anywhere, are they? Anyway, the cost of this is about £4,900. My God, just imagine how many wonderful caravan holidays you could go on with that. Why would you want to pay that for a couple of dimples? Dear me. It sculpts a diamond shape and two dimples into the back during vaser liposuction. The procedure is not painful. Well, thank God for that. Well, rather go there than a dentist, wouldn't you? But afterwards, in the first couple of days, you will experience aching that can be relieved by simple anglestic. I don't know what that word is. Anglestics. Is that some sort of thing that you rub on there or whatever that is? How awful, dear. Fancy having something done like that. My word. Actually, you know, I might might start going around. I might have a look for a pair of those pants. Let's have a look. One moment, please. What's bum... Bum enhancing pants. I bet you can get it off Amazon. Let's have a look. Yes, there's loads. Oh, women's ones. Well, there's loads of women's ones. Knickers pad panties shaper. Knickers pad. Here are girls. Knickers pad panties shaper bum butt hip booster enhancer. Ladies, £4.89 off eBay. Woman's buttocks, £5.99. lady buttock underwear, bum butt enhancer, brief pants, shapewear, £11.99. What about the men's ones? Hang on a minute. Men. Yes! What? Hang on a minute. Why are they so dear? Well, they're a bit dearer than them. Debenhams. Calvin Klein, body range, pack of two, black, slim. Don't think they fit me, the slim ones, were they, darling? Perfect body men's shorts, black, £30. Oh, that does look bloody uncomfortable, I must say. Oh, you look like you're all squashed in there. I don't think I want a pair of those. What else have we got? Men's padded underwear. Let's have a look at that one. This underwear, honestly, let me describe it to you. This is grey. £10.50 off eBay, that's better. So, men's padded underwear. It's got like two pads in the arse. What would make it look like egg? Shall I get a pair? Just to wear for the sake of it. I don't think they go around my waist. They're only £10.50. I might get some for myself. Hang on. Large, extra large. What shall I go for? The large ones? What colour? Navy or grey? Let's go for the grey ones. We like grey. We like grey tracksuits, don't we, lads? 9 available. Would that work? I don't know. Possibly not. Let's have a look what you're saying. John says, go down to the gym if you want to look young and sporty. Well, are you going to go then, John? I think you should take a little bit of your own advice there, me old mate. Down the gym, how boring is that? Oh, God. I mean, you're either gym or swimming. I like swimming. I can go up and down in the swimming pool, 60, as I do almost every day. I'll be going there a little bit later on after I've had my haircut. It's haircut day Friday. Every 2 weeks I go. And I must try and get my boy today. I got a boy who used to do it, right? But Ronnie has nicked my hairdresser, my mate. He'd come round and pick me up later and we'll go and get our hair cut. But he's nicked my hairdresser. How outrageous is that? Blimey. And then after that, we'll go to the swimming pool afterwards to get rid of all the little hairs. So that's what we do today. And that's when, as I say, that's why I go swimming. I go and do my 60 legs down there. Good morning to Terry Turner. Good morning, Terry. Lovely to see you. Who says, I need cosmetic surgery all over. Well, I didn't like to say anything, Terry. Just maybe a little bit here, lovey. A little bit there. I honestly don't think a lot of that cosmetic surgery looks awful, especially on the face. And what are people with these women with these great big lips? Actually, there was a boy. There was a boy who had had these lips done several times and the doctor was warning him, you know, if you keep having this done, your lips are just going to go bang. Because there's so much in there. I mean, it must feel awful to have great big thick lips on there, doesn't it? Let's have a look there. Wendy says it's £17. Thank you, Wendy. So Adam has lost £17 in 3 weeks. Isn't that good? That's very, very good indeed. Very good. Tim says she loves Let It Shine in comparison to The X Factor in an interview in today's Metro. Who's that, Tim? Lulu. Oh, I like Lulu. I love Lulu. Yeah. You know you want to make it shout and all that business. Yes. Thank you, Adam, for sharing this programme. John says I should buy a pair of those pants and model them on the show. Would you like me to do that? How much are they? £20. I'll do that. I'll get a... I can't just be wearing the pants on here. Do you want me to? Should I put them under a pair of jeans? I doubt that the jeans will go over them. They're tight enough as it is. I've got stretch jeans now. Stretch jeans. Someone has suggested jeans with elasticated waists. Apparently they go down quite well as well, don't they, eh? Has anyone got those? I think Ray Reynolds has got those. Jeans with elasticated waist. Is that right, Ray? 0208144 3477. If you want to call in this morning, 0208144 3477. Now, so first of all, we're talking about weight. We're not happy with our weight, are we? Look what's come through the post for me today. Or yesterday. You ready for this? Not happy. Time to choose your pension. Because next year, at this time, just before this time, I'll be 55. And I've got a little private pension. It's nothing much. It's not loads of money. We're talking, actually, £50 a month. That's all it is. But there's a bit of a lump sum there. And I've got to choose what I want to do with it. It's not automatic. You don't automatically start getting a certain amount. Anyone else got the pension yet? This is the private one, not the government one. Now, yesterday, I went on the government website for pensions, because you need to check, if you're of an age, you need to check that you're going to get the full pension when it comes out. Now, I think that comes at 67 years old. So I've got a long way to go before that. But you have to have contributed so much money over the years on your national insurance thing, don't you? Some people call it a stamp, but it's not. It's not, no stamp or anything like that. Doesn't matter. It's all on the internet now, isn't it? So you need to have contributed so many years towards this to get the full pension at the end of the year, at 67, when it starts coming. And I went online. Oh, what a lot of faffing about that was. They have to check your identity and all that business. You need your driving license out, you need your passport and all this business. And eventually I did it. And I'm pleased to say that by that time, by the time I'm 67, as long as I keep contributing my national insurance things, then I will be eligible for the full pension. So that's all right. But next year I can start getting my 55-year-old pension, and I've got to choose. And it's so complicated. It really is. Now, I could take all of it out at the same time, the whole lot. But if I do that, I will be taxed. Now, where does it say that? Pension-wise, you can get options for using your pension pot. Here we go. Keep your pension savings where they are and take them later. See page 10. You go to page 10. What's it say here? Your pot continues to grow tax-free until you need it, potentially providing more income once you start taking money out. You can continue making contributions. However, there are restrictions on how much you can save each year. So that goes on like that. Or you can use it to get you a guaranteed income for life. In my case, as I say, I think it works out to about 50 quid a month. Now, that seems bad now. But can you just imagine if I'm still here 40 years later, 50 quid a month, that might buy me a pint of milk, mightn't it? If the world is still here, incidentally, because it's all going on, isn't it, dear? Nuclear and environment and all that business. Use your pension pot to provide a flexible retirement income. It says take 25% of your pension pot or 25% of the amount you allocate for this option. And it's just so complicated. Now, take a number of lump sums. Now, here's the one I couldn't get my head around. The first 25% of each cash withdrawal from your pot will be tax-free. So are they saying, if I was to take, say, £100, right? If I was to take £100, do I get £25 tax-free and then do you get taxed on the other £75? Or does it mean you get 25% of the whole amount tax-free and then you get taxed on the other 75%. So if you only take out a little bit of it and not up to 25%, does that mean you get all of it? I can't work this out. So I might have to go and see my independent financial assistant, advisor, who I go to sometimes. But that's what comes from my door. Look at that. Your pension, it's time to... Anyone else had one of these? Very, very complicated indeed. Dear, dear me. Very complicated. I'm talking to myself there. Shut up, Chris.
Financial
Shut up.
Assistance.
Hang on a minute. There we are. Sorry. I'm going round in circles there. Terry says, didn't Grace Grubb Brothers sell something similar in the 1970s? I think they did. I think Grace Brothers did actually sell those special bum-enhancing pants on the TV show. I remember that. Did you see the remake of Are You Being Served? I thought it was very good, actually. Really good indeed. But the papers didn't like it at all, did they? They didn't like that. Never mind. All right. Let's have a look. What have we got here? Got my newspapers up there. Now, this is very, very worrying, dear. Very worrying. In this morning's Daily Mail again, the Royal Navy currently has no hunter-killer attack submarines on active duty. Five of the seven in service are said to be undergoing maintenance work. What, they painting them, dear? Are doing a little bit of painting in there? New kitchens, that sort of thing. Nice new soft beds, like they have in the Premier Inns. That's always a nice stay, Premier Inn. You don't want to stay in a two-star hotel. Not very comfortable, dear. My friend, a friend of mine, Victoria, her name is, she went to Thailand and In a way, I'm jealous because she's one of those people that can just pack her bags and off she goes. Doesn't matter. She doesn't book anything at the other end usually. But they had booked her, and I think her and her boyfriend had booked the very first night's accommodation. So they jumped in a cab, gave this bloke, you know, the address on a piece of paper. And this car went whirring through, and it ended up going down this side street and through lots of people and all that. And he said, right, it's here, it's down there. And they looked out, and it was down this, like, dark alley. Because, of course, it's nighttime now. People hanging around the alleys and all that sort of thing. I would have been awful. They got to this place, which was something ridiculously cheap, like £2.50 a night or something like that. She said, well, the beds were like slabs of concrete. Well, I couldn't stay anywhere like that. I do like a nice, comfortable, prestige haven holiday caravan. Thank you very much. Anyway, back to this story. The HMS Astute is at sea, but is still undergoing tests following an inspection. It comes a day after the RAF scrambled jets to intercept Russian bombers. So we haven't got any submarines working at the moment. Now, normally, this would be of worry, wouldn't it? You know, generally, people would worry that there are no submarines protecting the United Kingdom. But you forget, we have Theresa May, dear. We've got Mummy Theresa May. She is looking after us all now. What could possibly happen to us now that Theresa May is looking after us? She will just give them a look and they will turn round and go the other way. So I don't think there's too much to be worrying about there. Thank you very much. Last night, I've got to say, the people that come and watch the drag acts now, I find it all a bit worrying, really, because last night we had an excellent artiste on, Myra Dubois, who's very, very entertaining, but they just weren't watching or listening. You know, so imagine this. So I'm on it's a small stage. Actually, the stage is about only twice the size of this room. Is actually very small. You'd be surprised how small this room is. I have had, on occasions, very, very rare visitors. Nikki French has been up here. Oh, yes, dear. Yes. Nikki French has been in this studio. Only sung for the UK for the Eurovision Song Contest a few years ago. She came second to last, but that's neither here nor there. She came here in this studio and we had an interview many, many years ago. Yes. So it's quite small in here. The stage in front of me on a Thursday night is only about twice the size of this room, maybe a little bit more, 2.5 times the size. And I'm at the back of the stage, and you bring on the artist, singer, drag act, whatever. They come on the side and start doing the show. People just don't listen. It's like they're not interested anymore. I don't understand it. Oh, we could be having a sneeze come up here. What happened? Where's my tissues? I had tissues. Oh, just a minute. Nope, it's gone. It's gone. It's okay. Let me just blow my nose. Oh, that's better. And people just don't want to watch. It's strange, really, because when we're doing the karaoke shows, generally people watch karaoke people singing, but why are they not watching the drag anymore? Really, really good drag as well. As I say, last night we had someone called Myra Dubois, brought her on stage, and people are just, you know, backs turned to the stage or on the old mobile phone, tap, tap, flick, flick, tap, 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 flick, flick, having loud conversations with friends and things like that. I just don't get it. And I do wonder where we're going to be in 10 years' time. When I started working with cabaret, you'd bring the cabaret on and everything would stop. And everyone would stand and face the stage and watch what was going on. Doesn't happen anymore. And it's not just a few people. I would say it's 75-85% of the people. Now, it wasn't particularly busy last night, but 75-85% of the people are just not looking at the stage or having their own conversations, completely ignoring everything else that's going on. But I just think it's rude. I really do think it's rude. Where are we going to be in 10 years' time? I don't think I'd like to be an artist like a drag act or something like that. I've never done anything like that. I can't be wearing ladies' clothes, I'm afraid. I'm sorry, I can't do it, dear, no. John says, why do people go out if they don't respect the artist on stage? Yeah, that's what I mean, John. That's what I mean. I mean, I feel rude sometimes. You know, sometimes while I'm doing a karaoke, generally, you know, I'm in the middle of whatever it is, whether it's a stage or just a pub floor, and the singer will be somewhere there. People come up, some of them need to talk to you. Oh, can you help me with this? And I've got to sort of lean over the stage while I'm there and have conversations. And I think I'm being rude doing that, but it's not a lot you can do because it's me's got to keep the whole thing running, if you see what I mean. Some people do come up, and if they try to have conversation for the sake of having conversation, I've got to concentrate on the air over there, you know, and they generally understand as they go away, but you can't have a conversation while there's someone on the stage. I just think it's really rude. Terry says, in 10 years time we won't be leaving our homes. Well, that's good news for me. More viewers, dear. Only 10 million today, as you can see. Terry says, never seen a drag act, but would love to see Paul O'Grady as Lily Savage. Well, I used to see him when he first started at a place called the Dog and Fox in Wimbledon. He was rude. We loved it. And he had this puppet thing. I think it was a dog on his arm, something like that. Terry also says, I love a Premier Inn hotel and their buffet breakfast. I bet you take some of that home in a box, don't you? Yes, I reckon you will do. All right, we're going to wrap up this morning, boys and girls, because I think my mate's going to be coming around. Oh, I just wanted to say, email here from Chris Lotz. Hello, Chris. He says, so I'm finally caught up on your videos. I would love a coffee mug if you have any left. However, it would cost an arm and a leg to ship it over to the States. Well, I've done a few over there. That's okay. So we can do this. Could I request one, but have you give it to Auntie Brenda? That way, it saves you dollars in shipping and gives Auntie Brenda a cool mug from you and from a fan of the show. What do you think? If that's what you want to do, Chris, I shall do that, sir. I shall absolutely do that. Good idea. I shall give one of my special mugs to Auntie Brenda. Thank you, darling. Thank you. Today's birthdays, then. Let's do today's birthdays, boys and girls. Happy birthday this morning to Steve M. Hello, Steve, who is one of our regular karaoke singers. He does all rock and roll generally most of the time. Steve M. Happy birthday to you, Steve. All right. A little bit older than me, aren't you? 67. That's a good age. Good age, Steve. Happy birthday, Steve. Happy birthday today to Brian Windsor. Happy birthday, Brian. To Reece. Oh, it's little Reece, 23 today. Happy birthday, Reece. Hope you're doing all right. Happy birthday, little Reece. Happy birthday to Miss Hayley Licious. I like that name. 26 today. Happy birthday to Garri Adbo Atkinlade. 28 years old today. I hope I said your name right there. Rob Raymond. Hello, Rob Raymond. Raymond. Rob Raymond of Radio Fame is today 28 years old. Happy birthday. Leon Corrigan is 34. Are you 34 now, Leon? Good God, dear. 34. You're not going to try and sell me a picture of any mixer, are you? Happy birthday, Leon. Little Simon Miller, I'm still waiting for that chicken and rice that you promised me years and years ago. 38 years old today. Happy birthday, Simon. Happy birthday to Mark Sohn, 47 today. Happy birthday, Mark. Lots today, isn't there? Selalu Disini is 27 years today. A little picture of a rabbit on your Facebook profile. And Matt Kelton is 30 years old today. They're the birthdays today. Let's sing a song, shall we? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you. All right? Enjoy your birthdays, boys and girls. That's it on the show today. Being a Friday night, I shall be hosting karaoke tonight at Central Station in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross. It's every Friday. You'll see the new poster appear very, very shortly on my Facebook profile, okay? Advertising the Friday nights. It's 8:30 till midnight this evening at Central Station in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross. You don't have to sing if you don't want to. Just come and enjoy the other people there. We all have a bit of a fun and a bit of laugh, and it's nice you can just sit there and watch if you want. That's okay, you're not forced to sing. No one forces you to sing. Come and meet our wonderful, wonderful characters that we have at Central Station on a Friday night. That's Central Station, Wharfdale Road, King's Cross for the Friday night karaoke. Free entry, of course, and it starts at 8:30 and finishes at 12 midnight. All right, that's it for the show today. I might pop back later and try these two cameras out. I don't know yet. Or we might just leave it till tomorrow. It depends on the time. I haven't heard from my mate yet. I would have thought he'd have rung by now. Maybe he's watching. I doubt that very much. Thanks for watching and listening. See you soon. Bye-bye now.